Another special speaker up on stage, and this is Mr. Michael Lum, who will actually shed light on the topic, coaching yourselves for challenges at your life stage. And of course, Mr. Michael Lum is a certified ICF coach, NLP trainer, an NGH hypnotist, IACT stressologist, laughter yoga instructor, and AMA trainer. He also holds a Bachelor of Accountancy and Master of Commerce and is an associate lecturer in the university. An author of 3 books, he has been coaching and training for the last 18 years in major institutions. So ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together and welcome our next speaker for today, Mr. Michael Lum.
Thank you very much for the rich applause, which I richly deserve, but I still don't get. My name is Michael Lum, and I love organic nuts. And I am an introvert. And recently, I came out of the shell. And this is all about me in a nutshell. Now today, we are going to tell you about coaching yourself in various stages. Now this is a big topic, you know, I'll take 7 days to talk about it. Now, but being very intelligent people, I'm going to do only 33 minutes. Now, how many of you would be happy if I cover in 33 minutes all the issues that you face in your life in various stages? Hands up. Okay, the rest are not so interested. Okay, now, how many of you are interested in just the techniques on how to handle the challenges in life? Hands up. Okay, thank you. You are in the right place. Now, this is an important day in history. 15 September 1997. Can someone in the audience tell me what happened in that day? Anyone? I beg your pardon? Asian crisis? No. It is one day before Lee Kuan Yew's birthday. His birthday is on 16. Yes. I know because mine is quite close. Okay. Now, it is on this very day, 15 September 1997, that the world divide you and me. Okay, and we are divided into BGs and AGs. Yes. Now, on 15 September 1997, Google was launched, and the whole world is divided into BGs and AGs, and that's what we are here today. Now, from the back of the room, I can see some shining heads. Right? So I know there are a lot of retirees, people who are past 50s here. Now, Google promises us a new generation, and this is all the AG. Now, with this AG, we have a new generation, with you and me and you and you and you face. Now, what are the issues that we face? Number one, we are the late challenge. You know, everything is late. We get up late, we go to school late, we study late, we eat late, you know, we graduate late, we marry late, we have children late, and we die late also. So this presents a major issue to us, right? Now, the second issue is we are mobile extension. Now, how many of you here did not bring your mobile here? Hands up. You did not bring your mobile here. Are you sure? I will check you. Yeah, please come up here. Yeah, please come up here. Yeah, I'll give you a copy of my book. Yes. Thank you very much. I really admire you, you know. The mobile phone is part of our lives, you know. Even we forgot to take from our house, you know, we take 1 hour back now to take. Now, the mobile phone is a natural extension of ourselves. Okay, so now we are having mobile phone in our wallet, in our pocket. Soon, it will be in the arm, in our head. You know, soon, very soon, like in 10 years' time, when you see people wearing mobile head, you know, on the head, yes. Now, so we have this major problem, a major electronic extension throughout our body. Now, another issue we have is everybody go organic. Who take organic food here? Hands up. The rest take junk food. There's no such thing as junk food, no. Either it, there's junk and there's food. Okay, one more time. Who take organic food here? Hands up. 80% or it's okay. 50% and more. Now, this is going to be a major revolution. Now, look at the NTUC. In the past, I cannot go to NTUC to buy. I have to go to Middle Road to buy, no? Right? Organic food. Now, NTUC section is getting wider and wider. And the mind paper asked me to talk about coaching yourself in the various stages. Now, you know all the three stages of our life, okay? Plus another two stages. Now, we know all that there are five stages in our life, but we can also divide them into various stages, okay? Now, for me, I will divide into three stages. Now, when you are young, you have time, you have energy, but you have no money. When you are working, you have the energy, the money, but you got no time. And when you're retired, you have the time, you have the money, but you have no energy. Now, you know you're getting older when you go on a holiday, and you know that your energy runs out before your money. Then you know that your age is catching up. Now, there's another way of dividing life into three stages. You can divide into youth, middle age, and looking good. Three stages. Now, we will come into the various stages and the issues we have. Number one is health. Now, we know that for women, we got a major issue. You know, we have menopause, mental, and menstrual. Do you realize that all these problems are caused by men? You know, the first three letters is by men, right? Now, then we have another major issue. You know, the major issue is a midlife crisis, you know? And that issue happens to me midriff. Now, not that I don't have six pack, I have six packs, you know? But my six pack is fiercely protected by a layer of stubborn fats. So getting this one is really difficult now. Now, so we got health issue as you go on. So take care of yourself. Now, the other day, I go to the doctor, and the doctor told me, like, as a man grow older, you have three problems. Number one, you feel less tired. Okay, and number two, you will become more impatient. Okay, and the third one, I can't remember. Now, as you grow older, you also succumb to a lot of injuries, a lot of sickness, right? So, you know, I'm very careful. You know, so you need to take care of yourself. Now, everywhere I go, I wash my hand. Okay? I wash my hand with soap. And then when I take MRT, I don't go on to the railing. No? Yes, I don't hold. You know, I just stand next to the railing. Because bacteria and germs are very common in glass, steel, and wood. Okay, so you need to take very good care of yourself. Your sense of balancing is gone. So, you know, when you walk, you know, when you climb upstairs, when you climb downstairs, be careful yourself. Now, my paper is very generous. He has given me a lot of publicity. You know, so can we give Damon and my paper a big round of applause for organizing it? I'm very thankful. Now, I actually submitted my caricature, and he refused to take my caricature. So I went to take a few beauty shots. And then I realized that I look really young in this photo. Yes, yeah. I realized that I don't have pimples, you know, but my pimples has break into wrinkles. Now, so on that day when my article came out, I was very happy. Okay, now, but what attracted me was not my article. No. What attracted me was the article on top. Yes. My paper has very good articles on the last two pages. Very good articles. Now, this article show you that you do not have to waste money in the gym. Who go to California Fitness Center? Hands up. Luckily, only one. Now, there is no need, you know. Okay, James, stand up. Okay, he's a regular gym. You know, I want to thank my face around. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, he's my good pal and my student, my friend. Okay, thank you very much. Give me a round of applause. Those Facebook fans will come, thank you very much. Now, I met one Malay guy, and he was very well built, you know. So I asked him, Which gym do you go? He said, no, I don't go to any gym. I said, how do you do it? He said, he only used one dumbbell. And there are people who use Pepsi Cola bottle, right, and they fill it with water, right? And this one, they using body weight, you know. So I'm doing it, I do stretching, you know, I do yoga position, the cobra position, right? Now, I'm going to buy a resistant belt, you know, which is only $30, and you do all sorts of exercises. It is the stretching exercises which your spine need. You know, you need to make your vertebrae flexible, you know, and adaptable. Now, the next issue we have is, of course, finance. Okay, it's a big issue. You know that money is getting smaller and smaller. This is my wallet. My money burns all the time, you know. So, when you come to a few years' time, we do not have enough money. Okay, so now what is my solution for this? What is my solution for this? Ensure that you have sufficient savings, right? Now, I have just bought an insurance policy last month. Okay, so I went to see the doctor. Doctor said, well, you are fit, better buy more. So I listened to advice, I bought another one. Now, here's the thing. How many of you here are not working? Hands up. You're not working. How many of you are working here? How many of you are running your own business? How many of you are running a part-time business? Now, I call my mentor. Okay. Now, for those who are working, including me, at our age, we cannot make enemies now. Yes, especially young people, those that are on their toes, especially they are scholars. Yes, especially in the government service, there's a rule, never step on young people's toe. Yes, so I'm very good. You know, I'm very good to my client. I'm a good boy, you know, so that they will stay for me for life. So my paper asked me to speak second speaker, I said okay. You asked me to speak 35 minutes, I said okay. Take only two questions, I said okay. Yes. So for those who are working, you know, there are so much issues now, of foreign talent, you know, there's no job security, you're on contract. So be a good boy, I'll be a good girl. Okay, so so you can prolong your product life. Now, this is my favorite topic, children. How many of you got children, hands up? How many of you got no children, hands up? How many of you got other people's children, hands up? Now, children are a wonderful thing, you know. Their expressions are treasures, you know. They deserve to be buried. Now, take care of your children. Because your children, and my children will decide on the type of nursing home we go to. You know, we are naughty now, what they'll send us to JB, you know? Yes. Yeah, so when my daughter asked me to fetch her from MRT, I dutifully fetch. Yes. Yes, and when she asked me to buy my paper, you know about G-Dragon and G-Generation, G-Generation, I duly buy. So take care of your children. Now, you know we have a major issue here. You know, I do a lot of my own survey. A lot of families want their children. They prefer their dogs. And even when they have children, they only have one children. Now, so my reading in 5 years' time, in 10 years' time, all the policemen in Singapore are from Bangladesh. Yes. When your house is on fire, you know, all the firemen are from Sri Lanka. You know, so we have an issue. Now, my suggestion is, you know, we have to replace ourselves as a national duty. You know, we need to have two, you know. You know, a lot of people are complaining, you know, every day on Facebook, you know, we are not doing anything. So I think that it's good to have children, you have two, and children to Asian are a form of security. Now, this is our greatest fear, emptiness. Okay, this is our greatest fear. Now, so when you are empty, you know, you can call me, you can have a cup of coffee. In Papayo, Lulu 1 or Lulu 8. Now, this is a very real problem. You're in Sunday Times today. Okay? Now, so I have a little suggestion, okay, for you, which I will show you in the next slide. Now, we need to be very close to our children, take care of yourself, you know, because our children will leave home. Now, not only your children leave home, your children will work in the regional centers, Indonesia, you know, Malaysia, Tokyo, Hong Kong, right? Because we are operating as a spoke and a hub. So they are based in Singapore, they will fly 2 weeks to Tokyo, come back, you know, stay for 1 week, go to Dubai for 1 month, come back, you know, go to Indonesia. So this is the latest working scene. Now we need to have friends as we grow up, as we feel lonely. Now, how many friends do we need to have? How many friends do you think you need to have?
Five.
Who say five? Hands up. Who say four? More than five? Two? One? Now, psychologists have found that you only need one close friend. Right? But that close friend is someone where you can disclose your darkest secret to. Now, you will know your friends on the day you retire. You know, on the day we are made useless, on the day, you know, we are retrenched from the company, then you will know your friends. Young lady, you have been laughing all the time. You make sure you understand what I'm talking about. You know, it's true. You know, now you got lunch buddies, right? The minute you're retrenched, or the minute you are asked to leave, your friends will say, sorry, I can't go to lunch today, I got an appointment. You know, you will know your true friends the day you leave your company. Now, this is my favorite topic. It's not pottery or ghost or tell me more. Okay? This is my favorite topic. Now, how many of you here have hobbies? How many of you don't have hobbies? Now, there are people with no hobbies. Now, after about 15 years of teaching and lecturing and training, I come to this conclusion. You must have hobby. Hobby make you happy. Okay? And hobbies make your life more meaningful. Now, it also increase your self-worth, your self-esteem. It keep you busy, keep you young, you know, and also generate some cash flow. Now, let me give you an example. Okay, now, there was in the class, a few years ago, there was a lady. She got in the civil service. She's in the 50s. She's single. So I asked what she do. She learned and does pottery in Kampung Glam CC. Kampung Glam CC is the only CC in Singapore where you have the kiln. Now, so what she intended to do is, when she retired, she went and teach pottery. Occupy your time. Now, teaching pottery in the CC may not get you much money, right? But it's enough for petty cash. And at the same time, she sells the pottery. Is it a good idea? Say yes, please.
Yes.
Now, so look for hobbies, you know, for your future. Now, my finance manager started a stamp shop. You know why? He started a stamp shop because the grandfather in Penang left behind not a big bundle of cash, but boxes of stamp cards, antique stamps. So it's not a stamp collection. Now, so for you, look for hobbies for your future. But for me, it's speaking and writing. You know, I write part-time in the evening. We're going to see my book. I can see you in tea break. Now, where do I go from here? Where do we go from here? That is the question. Now, number one, I will ask you to pause. You know, in a computer, laptop, you got to pause. You know how things have changed? Things have changed a lot. You know, in the old days, application was for employment. A program is a TV show. A cursor used profanity. A keyboard was a piano. A web is a spider home. A virus was a flu. A CD was a bank account. A hard drive is a long trip on the road. And a mouse pad is where mouse live. Now, so borrowing the computer technology, it is good to pause your life for a while and think. Okay, what you need to do, what you've done, and how do you move forward? Have you got enough insurance? Have you got enough savings? You know, are you on good terms with children? You know, have you got any hobbies? Have you got any finance? Right? Now, then what you do is that you do not stop your life. You reset the life. You know, you hit the reset button. You know, and go from here. Remain active is very important. Think young, participate in activities. So when you exercise, when you take organic food, you will remain active. Now all these things are very easy to find. You just Google, you got a lot of activities. Okay, yoga, tai chi, jogging, you know, swimming. All these are very good for you. Okay, and I use a lot of organic products. Okay, so uh, my My face cream is all organic. Yes. Even my hair is organic. Yeah. You know how you do it? Who go to the hair salon and dye your hair? It's very bad, you know. You know, because it got a lot of chemicals. So what I do, I'm an Indian student and taught me, you buy henna from Little India. You know, and every weekend, Saturday I use olive oil, Saturday I use coconut oil. Yeah, today I cannot use after I smell of coconut. Yeah, so today I stop. You know, and every night, yeah, before I sleep, I swipe my face, you know. Yeah, don't laugh. You know, when you swipe your face, all the estrogen, testosterone, all are released, you know. Yep. So I do also exercises, you know. Okay. Also remain young, participate in activities. You can see in CC now, a lot of elderly people participate in activities. Now be curious, learn every day. Okay. Now people laugh at me because I'm different. I laugh at them because they are the same. Now, so my philosophy is life, it's three things. Now this philosophy, I must acknowledge, it's not from me, you know, because I teach classes, you know, I just taught Thursday and Friday classes, you know. So a lot of participants give me ideas, so I live by three principles. Number one, I always do something different. Today, I do something entirely different. I speak to 200 odd audience in SPH Auditorium. Right, so do something different. Okay, and when you do something different, you find your life is very enriching. Okay. Now afterward, you're going to take MRT from Braddell, right? Don't take. Okay, walk to Topaya Central. Take a walk. Yep. I do something different all the time, you know. And you know, women find life very exciting because you go hair salon, you know, you got new hairstyle, you know, new color, right? You know, you buy a new handbag, you know, you wear different colors, you know, right? Now when I wear a pink shirt like you, a bit to say, you know, I'm a bit not straight. Right? So do different things all the time. Every day I try to do something different. Okay? Now, another philosophy is help someone. Okay, so I give advice on the phone, MRT, I give direction, you know, I help to talk to someone, you know, and I help to carry the pram. Now, when you help someone, you do something different, life is very enriching. And last but not least, I learn something different every day. And now it's very easy to learn because of Google. Okay, we are the AG generation. So every time I come across something in the newspaper, I will go and Google. Right? Now, how many of you heard of Penske, the street graffitis? Penske? It was in the Sunday Times, Straits Times. Penske was a street graffiti artist. And he saw his work in New York Central Park unannounced. The painting is only $60. People bargain $30, they still sell, and the painting is total worth $31,000. So straight away I Google, and I hope that guy come to Singapore, you know. Yeah. Yes. Nobody buy his painting. He's a world-renowned artist. Nobody buy his painting. So things like this I Google. Draw a plan. Okay, manual line is here. Okay, Yona Fu is here. Okay, draw a plan. So that you can proceed with life. Now a plan is very useful. Do it on a piece of paper or do it in a notebook. So normally I do it in a coffee bean or Starbucks, you know, in the lonely corner. Okay, that's where your thoughts come out. Last but not least, I wish you all the best, and I have two words to describe you. Of all the audience I spoke to, you are the awesomely risen audience. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Michael Long. And of course, we'll be opening up the floor once again to anyone who would actually like to ask Michael here some questions. Please don't be afraid to approach the mic. Even if you're far away from the mic, we have our facilitators here to actually pass you some microphones to speak from where you're sitting. So does anybody have a question for Michael? I think it was a very interesting insight as to how we should live our life, don't you think so? Because, you know, we have to try something new. And I want to ask Michael a question. Michael, how do you stay positive like that all the time? That's one thing that we try hard to do every day. Because you face with, like, challenges every day, work, problems at work, at home. So how do you actually find that amount of positivity to keep going?
You know, to be positive, you need to be very fit first. Right, so LKY is not correct. You need to be very fit. And those of you on my Facebook, I attend a lot of seminars. You know, I attend a lot of seminars both locally and overseas, and I read a lot. Okay, so do not mix with toxic people. Okay, that's what Andy Robbins say. You know the Mexican crab, when you put a crab, right? When they catch the crab in the net, the crab will try to climb up, you know, right? Now the second crab will drag the first crab down. Right? So do not mix with toxic people, do not mix with depressing people, mix with positive people. Now how many of you got children here? Children, the same thing. Children, mix with top students. You know, you create the environment to be top, correct? These men agree, but please don't mix with me, you know. Yeah. Because all my life I want to be an outstanding student in class, and I end up standing outside the class. Any other question?
Anybody has any questions for Mr. Michael Lau? But if you're afraid, yes, ma'am, we've got one lady there. Can you introduce yourself, ma'am, and of course your question?
I'm Susan. Sorry I came late, I overslept. I work very hard, don't get me wrong, because I'm sleeping in the afternoon. Okay, Michael, thank you for sharing so much with us. I would like to say that at the end of the day, what is important is that we would like to leave a legacy if we can. So what's your legacy?
I have written some books, you know, so those are my legacy, and I tend to write some more. Yeah. So my legacy is not so important, you know. It is your legacy that's important, you know. See, today's seminar is not about me, you know, right? Today's seminar is I'm sharing with you, right? So, and those things I share with you is not for me. A lot of them are for other people. So I hope that I can make your life complete, you know. Now, please do not use the word finish, you know. Use the word complete, you know, from learning or this seminar. You know, one Facebook friend told me the difference between complete and finish. When you men meet a right woman, you are complete. When you meet a wrong woman, you are finished. Now don't laugh yet, huh? When the right woman caught you with the wrong woman in a car, you are completely finished. Harvest, one done, you know, mark the moment. Okay, so from there on, don't laugh, huh? And don't use the word finish now. So, you know, hopefully this life will make us complete in our health, in our insurance, you know, in our education, in our children, in our home, you know, in our friends, you know, in our society. Yeah, thank you very much. Okay, my pleasure.
Thank you, Michael. And once more, if you want to talk more to Michael, he will be outside at his booth, and he will be there to answer any other questions that you might have for the rest of today's session. Thank you, Michael. One more time, give an applause for Mr. Michael Lau, everybody.